Next is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th Canto, 9th Chapter, text number 34, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on March 12, 1976, in Mayapur, India.
Translation: from that great lotus flower from which Brahma is generated, certainly Brahma could not see anything else except the big lotus flower. Therefore, Lord Brahma, diving within the water, executed austerity and penance for 100 years, but still could not get any trace of you. The reason is that when a seed is fructified, the original seed cannot be seen.
Tatsambhava kavirata anyat apasamanasyam bijam atmanitatam sa bahir vichintya. Rabindrat abdasata afru nimajjamana jatin ture katham upalabhatir bijam. So, from the beginning of the creation, the same illusion is continued. Brahma, when he was born, created, he was created not by ordinary father and mother, but he was created and a lotus flower stem which grew from the navel of Mahavishnu, Garbhodak Sai Vishnu. Therefore, Brahma's another name is Ojo. He's not born like ordinary human being. Sayambhu. He is also known as Svayambhu. Everyone is born by father and mother. But he was born, of course, father was there, Garbhodak Sai Vishnu, but he did not come through the womb of mother. This is omnipotence. Lord Vishnu is lying on the sesha bed, and Lakshmiji is engaged in the service of massaging the lotus feet of Vishnu. But Vishnu did not take the help of Lakshmiji to beget Brahma. He personally begot from the navel. Therefore, we should understand that the Supreme Personality of Godhead can perform anything He likes from any part of His body. That we chant always, Angani jasya sakalendriya vittimanti. We have got knowledge, experience. Then when a child is born, it has got a different source of being born. But Garbhodak Sai Vishnu wanted the child be born from the navel and not from the mother of the navel. There was no mother, but the father himself. This is called Angani Jasya Sakalendriya. Every part of the body, every limb, has got the potency to act like other parts of it. We can see only with the eyes, but God can see with His finger. That is God. We can eat through mouth, but God can eat from any part of His body. If he simply touches his toe, he can eat. If he simply glances over the foodstuff offered to him, he has eaten it. That we do not know. Therefore, we sometimes surprise that how is it that you are offering so many nice things, it is lying down there, how I shall understand that he is eaten. Yes, he has eaten. Simply by seeing, he has eaten. And because he is nijalabhapurna, he is satisfied by his own self. Therefore, by simply glancing, he has eaten and it has become prasada. You can take it. This is the meaning of angani jasya sakalendriya vritti. So, those who cannot understand the omnipotency, they speak of omnipotency, but they do not know what is that omnipotency. They describe sometimes God is omnipotent, but they do not know how the omnipotency acts. Here are some of the examples. Those who are devotees, they can understand. Non-devotees, they call this mythology. This is not mythology. Real fact, but foolish people who do not know how Krishna or his confidential devotees act, they do not know it. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has said that jai bhaje sei boro abhakta hin cha. One who is devotee.